This video presents probabilistic degeneracy detection for point-to-plane error minimization. LADA-SLAM is widely used for robust localization and mapping in challenging environments. However, LADA-SLAM is susceptible to failure in geometrically uninformative environments such as cylindrical tanks, tunnels, and open spaces. The lack of information renders the underlying geometric optimization degenerate. This experiment demonstrates the detrimental effects of degeneracies on LIDAR-based state estimation. The geometry is uninformative in the longitudinal direction of the tunnel. Spurious information from noise masks the degeneracy, and the translation is grossly underestimated. To deal with degeneracies, we propose a new probabilistic degeneracy detection method that we integrate in real-time degeneracy-aware ICP. The approach is validated in 4 real-world experiments. The degeneracy detection method considers the noise entering the Hessian of the linearized point-to-plane optimization problem. The Hessian can be decomposed into a signal component and a noise component. Noise dominates the signal in degenerate directions. We therefore require the signal to be at least an order of magnitude higher than the noise for direction U to be considered non-degenerate. P sub U quantifies the probability that direction U is non-degenerate. To compute non-degeneracy probabilities, we use Gaussian noise models for the points and normals used to construct the Hessian. To account for degeneracies in real-time LIDAR-SLAM, we integrate the degeneracy detection in point-to-plane ICP for scan-to-map point cloud registration. We modify the update step of the standard algorithm. We shrink the point-to-plane perturbation by using non-degeneracy probabilities computed for each of the eigenvectors of the Hessian. The degeneracy-aware perturbation is damped in degenerate directions, while non-degenerate directions are unaffected. The proposed approach is validated in 4 real-world experiments. To that end, we integrate our approach in the CompSLAM framework, which relies on LOW for LIDAR data. For experimental comparison, we implement the degeneracy detection methods of Zhang et al., Hindu et al., and Li et al. Within the same framework. For our method, we select parameters ahead of time based on information from LIDAR datasheets. The method of Zhang et al. Must be tuned experimentally, while the final two methods are parameter-free. In the first experiment, we compare our method to the baselines in a large open area. The antibiotics animal C robot enters the area and rotates in place. The field of view of the Velodyne VLP16 LIDAR is reduced to 180 degrees to increase the difficulty. The baseline methods yield drift in the map, while our method does not. The second experiment uses the same platform but with a full 360-degree field of view of the LIDAR. The robot traverses a confined tunnel section in a mine. The method of Zhang et al. Yields translational drift. The method of Hindu et al. Does not exhibit degeneracy-induced drift. The method of Li et al. Yields translational drift. Our method does not exhibit degeneracy-induced drift and yields the best absolute pose errors overall. Our method successfully generalizes between experiments 1 and 2 with the same parameters. Additionally, we use this dataset to experimentally validate the choice of considering directions as non-degenerate when the signal is at least an order of magnitude higher than the noise. The third experiment uses an aerial robot in a cylindrical environment. The field of view of the Ausdur O064 LiDAR is reduced to 180 degrees to increase the difficulty. The method of Zhang et al. Yields rotational drift as it fails at detecting the rotational degeneracy. The method of Hindu et al. Yields a particularly noisy map due to estimation errors in both rotation and translation. Finally, the method of Li et al. Yields drift in rotation and translation. Unlike the baseline methods, our method does not exhibit degeneracy-induced drift. In the final experiment, we use a similar robot as in experiment 3. The robot has an Ausdur O0128 LiDAR, and we use its full field of view. The method of Zhang et al. Underestimates the tunnel segment by approximately 110 meters. The method of Li et al. Yields significant lateral drift as it erroneously classifies lateral translation as degenerate throughout the experiment. Our method and the method of Hindu et al. Correctly estimate the length of the tunnel segment to about 500 meters. Our method uses the same parameters as in experiment 3 and successfully generalizes across the two environments. We have presented probabilistic methods for degeneracy detection and degeneracy-aware ICP. In 4 experiments, we have demonstrated improved performance and generalizability compared to the state-of-the-art. Additionally, parameter selection is simpler than for the method of Zhang et al. Due to our method's first principles formulation. The method runs real-time with limited overhead. The code for our method is available open source on GitHub. Please see our paper for more information about the method and the experiments.